Okay, so today Ian's, if you don't know, he's our guy that represents us in Nowhere. He's been running the branch out there for ages. We've actually been training together since 2008 or 9 now.
Long ass time.
And Ian has an extensive background anyways. He's been training for, what, 30 odd years?
29 years.
So nearly, he's been training for nearly 30 years, right? 3 decades. With a lot of different stuff, and you've got a bit of Wing Chun experience, right?
Yeah, a little bit, mostly via Jeet Kune Do, but I've done a little bit of different kinds of Kung Fu and a little bit of Wing Chun and stuff. Certainly have studied the principles and practiced it on my own, you know, that kind of stuff, so.
Right. And I've been exposed to it myself. I used to train it back in the day, but I worry that since being to Hong Kong a few times and actually going and researching it straight from the horse's mouth, so to speak, I found more of a pure sort of different styles. And there's two different styles with that. There's two schools on Nathan Road in Hong Kong and Galvin area. One from Leung Ting and one from the Practical Wing Chun School. And basically, you know, I'd heard a lot of different things about both of them and I just want to go and see for myself. And they're both great. They had both very different opinions. We're not here to say which one's better, or even with the Tong Long, it's not to say who's better, because there are a lot of different versions of that these days as well, which I'll give you an insight to in a second. But we're just looking at some fundamental concepts, which everyone's pretty much aware of. We're going to compare the two. So I know what works for me. I know which one that I liked better, which one seemed to actually suit what I was doing. But there's some reasons that I'll get into in a minute as to why I don't recommend it and why I don't actually teach it. Although I've done it for a very long time now, I don't actually teach it. Okay, and there's a reason, but we'll get to that in a second. So I'm going to start off with Ian going over some of the fundamental concepts or some of the generic concepts that you're going to come across in Wing Chun. So.
Okay, probably one of the first is, well, let's start with the stance. It seems like a good place to start. And one thing that's often criticized, but it's also one of the strengths potentially of Wing Chun, is definitely the sort of neutral stance that they adopt, where you can lead with either foot, okay? It's not very low. It's not like, you know, a boxing stance where you're dropping your weight a whole lot, where you need a lot of room. It's almost a natural katahaba, you know, sort of the fucking Japanese, shoulder widths apart, you know, very natural stance, and your hands just out front. And it's very similar to what you might see as like a de-escalating posture, this sort of like, you know, calm down, this sort of thing. It's very easy to shift to this. It's also very similar to the old style bare knuckle boxing stance, right? The same sort of center line, and the Jeet Kune Do also occupying that center line. So that's one of the places that you need to start in any Wing Chun discussion. Then another one is the simultaneous defense and attack. So, you know, if a punch comes, say we just need some sort of punch, okay, I'm going to defend, okay, defend against it with whatever it is, but I'm also attacking at the exact same time. So defending here, attacking there, okay, this sort of thing, right? You'll do these sorts of bong saos. You can do, you know, straight to the eyes, right over the top, right?
You do this one.
Yeah. Okay. This sort of right on the money.
Yeah.
Okay. This sort of thing, right to the eyes. Simultaneous attack and defense is a huge principle in Wing Chun. And then the last one that everyone is probably already familiar with is continuous attacking, right? The Chuk Chin Choi, the straight blast down the middle, right? We're occupying the center line again, straight from there, and just bah, 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 just rapid firing the punches down the middle. And, you know, continuous attack has a lot of value to it,
yeah.
I think. In the punch can be very powerful if you train it a lot. But, yeah, so three principles. Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that I found that people start to implement in their Kung Tao, when you've got Southeast Asian styles of Silat, Kali, those sort of things, or even the Jeet Kune Do, a lot of guys in the Jeet Kune Do take those sort of things that come from Jeet Kune Do and Wing Chun from here, the Pai Tong position, and they'll go and they'll do your gait changes. Now, this is so common because in the Southeast Asian arts, which again have been heavily influenced from Jeet Kune Do, believe it or not, actually look at those fundamental principles of, you know, distance, timing, levels of attack, as in high, mid, low, that sort of thing, angles of attack, gates, as in if we were to start here, we've got this sort of thing that we're going on the outside, and then if he's to block that, I could go to the outside, I could go to the inside of this attack, so forth and so on. So those progressions, I think in Wing Chun, looking at the gates and, you know, trapping and all that sort of thing, is really, really awesome. But it's not what you train, it's how you train it. Now, one of the things that I experienced going from Wing Chun to Tong Long was one of my mentors said to me, he said, hey, you've been training 90% trapping and 10% striking or whatever, majority of it being trapping, whereas in a real fight, it's majority striking, and if you're lucky with the position, you know, if that opportunity presents itself, you may get a trap. But, you know, most of the time, you're more so looking at just fucking hitting the guy. So the straight blast is really your go-to move. But we'll demonstrate a couple of those right now for you. Next, we're going to look at fundamental tong long. Okay, and basically, I've been doing that as my own self-perfection art for a long time now, and you know, I train to a level of what would be considered quite high in terms of the forms and all that sort of shit. But I've got no official rank or anything. I don't want to be using that to, you know, promote myself or whatever. But what I can tell you is that that is my base art, and that's what I know quite a bit about, because it looks at some of the styles of tong long now. We'll look at the applications, as in how each fist is used, for example, like how you can play each hand position, or whatever you want to call it, each fist, as we call it, right? But some of the styles, and one of the ones that I focused on was mainly the differences in energy, okay? So for example, if it's heavy energy, so if I enter here and go wham, and I stick to him, I'm heavy, I'm very, not just like bang, just hit him and pull back, it's very heavy and stuck to him, so I feel his center, I feel where he's going, I feel what's happening from there, and from there, a lot of things just happen from here. So mainly what we call a pei, pok, and gao. So the funny thing is, when I was training tong long, and I still do, believe it or not, my mentor, I just had him here a couple months ago, I just wasn't public about it, you know, we never trained any defense. It's never, if a punch comes, or if this comes, or whatever, it's whatever he puts up, that's just in the fucking way to get to him. So if he puts his hands up there, I'm gonna fucking mash him, and then I'll get here, whack, you know, just put that hammer fist in. You'll see I've got his foot here as well. But anything that comes out, one of the simple entries that we do, that I believe the Sioux brothers, you know, were very big on this as well. If you know anything about them, you know, if you don't, whatever. It's that do pei pok gao, like that, just dropping that gao toy, that hammer fist. So basically anything that gets put up in front of me, I'm just gonna fucking smash it. Sorry, dude. And this is the same thing, just smash. So it's all hammer fist. So that's where I got introduced to that. But what I've seen, in terms of hammer fist, what I've seen recently, I've been back to Hong Kong and I've trained a couple of times with the guys at Tong Long headquarters there. And it's funny because some guys are training with Ip Sui, now they're training with NCK, who's an amazing master, a friend, someone I dearly, you know, deeply respect. And some of the guys who were training with Ip Sui before and now NCK, they're like, oh, now it's the pure version, now we got this and that. It's you know, it is what it is. But NCK has always said to me, there's, you know, fundamentals, you know, basic things, and that's what I appreciate. But you see some guys that are teaching applications or how to use the form, and one of the drills that comes out from one of the forms, like this, for example, different hands, one will be here, one will be here, one will be here, one will be here, one will be here. I'm not going to go through, you know, Bilsar, Gernar Choi, you know, Tanzhao, all these sort of things, because a lot of people call them different things. My point is that what guys are showing these days is when a punch comes, they'll do this, they'll do this, they'll do this, and they'll do that, or they might go for the throat, which is more applicable in my opinion. They might even get rid of that and then go to their blast there. Just depends. But the way I was shown it was very fucking different, because it was just boom, and it was smacking the head and the eye and the ear, everything you can get, whilst going for the throat with that Bilsar there. So going bam, then coming back, hitting with Gyo-Nam Choi, they'll call that, to the side of the head, then here to the other side, and then the eye, or maybe the throat, depending on whatever you get. So Kamla or Kamna, depending on how you want to pronounce that. If he's to shape up, a lot of time we just train to fucking just come in and just crash that. And I actually told you about one of the Marines that used that on here, and his head just went from purple to white to red to, you know, eyeball ready to pop out, back to white again. And yeah, it fucking works really well. But the fundamental principle in Tong Long that is kind of similar to Wing Chun is the bridge principle, like having a bridge, having a connection between you and them. However, it's one of the first energies that we train is sticking and heavy sort of energy. So what Ian said before about the simultaneous defense and attack, they've got, say, Tan Sao, Zhong Choi, what do you want to call that, you know, the punch. They'll have these, they'll have Bong Saos and what have you. We have a similar thing in Tong Long, but what will happen is if like Wing Chun, if there's a punch to come, they might Bong Sao here and then sort of roll over and straight blast to there. What we'll do in Tong Long is I might Jan that, we'll call that an elbow, the Jan, and I'll roll over and actually hammer, and then here, wah, like this, and roll out to there and just strike. So it's much more aggressive, much more violent, and the reason it's called Mantis, a lot of times there's a lot of stories to this, but what was explained to me was basically female mantis after, I think, making sex to the male one, although not intending to fuck you.
Fucks that poor guy up.
Yeah, so tears the arms off first and then goes for the head. So that's always our thing, you know, what he's saying, what he's doing, how he's looking at me, it's not really going to harm me, but what's in his hands or what his hands are doing is what I need to be concerned of. So that's why we'll always smash them first. The whole thing about the bill sow, or you might call it doe, pay, gal, whatever, you know, we make that to have a focal point of energy here and then put a little nasty on that. So like I said before, when we've got the throat here, I've got bang, I'm hitting the side of the throat, but then I'm also, you know, cutting through that, what's that, the Scientology word for that? Voice box or fucking...
Scientology group?
Yeah. Anatomic.
The trachea?
Trachea. The trachea, you're actually just attacking that, coming back to the fucking temple here, the other side of the temple, the eye and the throat, and it's just all fucking really, really violent, you know, and I love it. The problem is that we had to, you know, counterbalance that with our Tai Chi, and there was a point where I was still bouncing, where I'd just become really fucking savage, and, you know, Ian was saying before about, you know, the guard of Wing Chun being like, you can be like this, or you can be however you want to be, but basically guarding the center line. Tom Long a lot of time will actually guard up like this and invite the center line and say, yeah, fucking come on. So if he's guarded up like this, and I'll be like this, you'll think that, you know, we're going to be doing these ones. That's not actually very common, unless I enter like so, I've invited him, he goes to enter, bam, like this, and then I come up and I hit the back of his nose. Now, we don't back fist in Tong Long, so to speak, but we'll actually hit with this part here, the back of the wrist, instead of the back of the hand. This just gives a focal point of energy to fucking bust his shit and then hit him, so we got that flick right there. One other thing many people comment on is that when they see our silat, or even some of the Tong Long drills that I was doing the other day on my one day off at the temple with my kid, I said, oh, it looks like Wing Chun. Is Wing Chun or what? It's like, well, if you've only ever done Wing Chun, of course it's going to fucking look like Wing Chun. It's, you know, it's in the same category. It's a Southern Chinese art. It's a Southern Kung Fu. But it's got some consistencies, but not all the same. What are the consistencies? Let's look at it. You know, we're generally within this vicinity here. We're very close range. There's a lot of stories as to why, but anyway, we're here, we're doing stuff in this vicinity. And one of the other things is the kicks. There's no, well, some people do high kicks, especially when they're advertising stuff or doing demos. But generally speaking, Wing Chun uses one that I like, a stomp kick. You go to the knee a lot of the time, the kick you just did before. I mean, how'd that go? Yeah, this one. We use the same sort of thing as a sidekick in RCI's combatives, because it's very good, because you stay front onto the guy, you're not doing these things. Although I still do see a lot of guys do this one, especially from the Jeet Kune Do. They'll sort of do the leg obstruction and all that sort of thing, and I'm like, yeah, it's got its place, but it's definitely not going to stop a guy shooting at you, you know, like a wrestler or whatever like that. Tong Long, for example, we, you know, the one main kick that we use, there are styles that implement quite a few others, but they'll call it like a shin tech, or shin kick. Straight up to the groin, wham, so it'll be, you know, you'll grab things, you'll be ripping, you'll be doing whatever, and it'll finish with a fucking, you know, taste your breakfast count sort of thing. So, yeah, it's very violent. The other thing is they'll come in, we'll do like a clinch, or we might have like a come down type thing, and we'll rip them down into a knee like this sort of thing. So I'll rip them into short, sharp little stuff like that, which can develop into a shin kick, obviously. But, yeah, that's something that's... obviously simple and brutal, you know, there's nothing, none of this fancy sort of stuff. When you look at the palms or the drills, you know, some of the hands, you think, oh, what's that for? But a lot of it's just energy, just to find the, you know, like I was saying before, you've got heavy and sticking. If we're to look at the move, the Tan Sao Dung Choi, like this, the Tan Sao from Wing Chun, we have a similar one in a lot of the drills in Tong Long. And there's a couple of versions of it from different forms. And one of them actually puts a bill sow on the end, so you've got a focal point and a bit of a nasty, you know, like I was saying before, you can whap like this to the eye. A lot of time we'll hit to the throat and then sort of throat jab like this, which is, sorry about that, it's a bill sow, bill G, or to the eye, so bam, like this, and then give another little bonus fuck you sort of thing at the end there. So in the forms, you'll see that, but it's more so, like I was saying before, more rather than being an application or how to use this fist, we look at more so tension release and the whole intrinsic energies of it. So I'm not claiming to be a master of anything of this stuff, but it's just something that I've been greatly interested in and I just want to share it. So anyway, one of the things, again, as Ian was doing before, simultaneously offense and defense, we have this also. You can do it from inside gate or outer gate, it does not matter. As Ian did before with Wing Chun, with the tantau, you can go here and go to the inside. I'll go from this punch so you can see. To the inside there, or you can be to the outer gate so you can tantau this one and then straight blast from there and wham, like so, okay? Nice. What Tong Long will typically do is if he puts a hand out, I go whoom like this. So this one's very ridgy, very heavy. Just one more time, like that. And this is a throat shot. So this is a fuck you sort of thing. Now from there, what I can do is also reach that up, like this. And what this does is cut through. So that'll actually hit that temple and get rid of that as well. And I might keep going. So a lot of times just keep blasting, you know. But that's something that's very typical of both. Very same, very similar posture that you find yourself in, and a generic concept that are consistent in both of them that I believe is, you know, that's what we sort of try and do. We sort of look at the consistencies rather than the differences, because each master, each mentor will have their own sort of point of view and the way they approach things and what they believe is gospel and what's right and what's wrong and all the rest. But, you know, I just try and stay impartial and go, oh yeah, that's cool, and try and see it from their point of view and then see if I can actually work it to implement it into my own training. So there's a lot of short, sharp sort of blurs of violence within this type of training. And that's why, what I was getting to before, when I was bouncing, you're naturally sort of very territorial, but when you've got to apply the shit and you just fucking, you're just training to fucking hurt people, it can get you in a lot of trouble, you know, and it happened to me here, even just hitting someone and going, oh fuck, I've made a mess, you know? It's like dropping a pie, you know?
Oh, I've done it again. Oh shit.
Fuck, what's gonna happen here? No, I've really fucked that one up, haven't I? You know, and there's just nothing left of them. So it's one of the arts that I think that expression of what I did, that as in that version of Tong Long that I did and still do, with my mentor and one other student that I practice with is something that I found very effective because of how we trained. A lot of iron shirt, a lot of iron skirt, a lot of iron palm conditioning, taking a lot of shots, giving a lot of shots, conditioning the hand, conditioning the chin, the throat, that sort of thing. Apparently that's not very common these days, but then when I went back to Hong Kong, they were doing it, like old guys taking groin shots and throat shots and conditioning the legs and the hands, and that was like 70% of training, and I really appreciated that. So all I'm going to say is I don't think that one or the other is better. It's really up to you. You know what I mean? We've trained a lot of different styles ourselves, and always trying to find, you know, what fits our body type, what we commonly encounter, what fits our logic. But for me, my sort of upbringing in martial arts, especially over the past decade and a half at least, has been some really serious Tong Long training. And it's not that Mantis style like this. It's the, you know, how the fuck are you, you know? That sort of thing. So yeah, it's always power based. We call a lot of base training, a lot of core training, and it's, you know, a lot of fucking, you know, short, sharp, whippy energies like that. So all in all, again, I just want to say we both appreciate Chinese martial arts. I'm not saying anyone's better or worse or anything like that. It's just a comparison based on our experiences. And you know, I've had quite a bit of Tong Long experience. I've gone back to Hong Kong, and even out throughout Malaysia and Australia with some great masters and teachers and mentors there, and tried to experiment with different people and see their point of view on it. Again, practical Wing Chun, going and visiting those guys in Hong Kong was amazing. Saw some big people from Brisbane there, from the UK, people from all over the place going to train with the Sifu there. He's amazing, really nice guy, really good approach. Yung Ting as well, despite things that I'd heard, I just thought, whatever, I'm gonna go try it for myself. And he was really cool. He took my daughter in, invited us in on an instructor development class. He had red belts on there, or instructors on there, I can't remember if they were red belt or whatever. But he was really good too. He has his own approach, it's quite different. I can see his approach to it, I can see where he's coming from, and he makes it work for him. So, you know, I think that before we start pointing fingers and saying this is better than that or whatever, you just gotta see if it works for you. You gotta train it until, like Dan Asante says, until you own it. So that's our two cents on those things. Anything else you want to add?
Yeah, I just want to reiterate the point you made about what works for you, because, you know, like, there's a lot of talk about, you know, especially in the era of MMA and, you know, jiu-jitsu or wrestling or Muay Thai or whatever it is the best martial art. There are a lot of people I know who would not be good at MMA or would not be good at Muay Thai because of a personality thing, because of a burden body. And personality isn't talked about enough, you know. If it doesn't match your personality, it doesn't fit you. It's like clothes, you know? I mean, Luke's got a very heavy personality. It doesn't surprise me that the martial art that fits him is a heavy style martial art. Mm. So, yeah, I mean, find what fits you.
Yeah, I like to be on top.
He does. He's a power top, you might say.
No lube, straight in, straight through the cloth.